fucking lying there, straight to you like a pig. Go see him. Go fucking tell him, and you came as soon as you could.
What a fucking mess.
I don't have time right now, and I believe you have work to do.
Smell. The stud farm owner. I saw him in Scallets a few times. His poor widow.
Ask.
I can come back later if you...
No. I saw you came with the soldiers, and the sooner you know everything, the sooner you'll catch those savages.
I'm sorry to trouble you, ma'am, but could you tell me about the raid?
The noise woke us up. Me and Smil. We thought the horses were restless, or maybe some drunk had staggered here from the inn.
Do you get drunks coming here a lot?
Sometimes, but not this time. My husband went out to see what was going on. Then I just heard loud voices and screaming. It's so stupid. It didn't even occur to me at first that something could have happened to Smil. I didn't find out until the morning.
Did you recognize any of the voices you heard?
No, but they spoke Czech, cursing like demons, even at each other.
At each other? They quarreled?
Yes. Something must have happened.
And where did you hear this noise?
Everywhere. It was chaos. I don't even know how many of them there were.
I mean at the very start. Do you remember where you heard the noise come from then?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Did you get a look at them? There's one man, huge, and dressed all in black. Did you see him?
No, I didn't.
Who should I question about the raid? Did anyone here see anything?
Jakob, the old stable boy. He even fought with them.
From what I've heard, Mark was the first one to wake. It might be a good idea to talk to him.
Ginger was sleeping in the stable. He might have seen something.
I don't know of anyone else.
Our stud farm isn't finished. I swear I won't let them destroy it, Smil.
Jesus, look where you're going.
Another useless soldier come to ask questions. You should have fucking been here last night.
I'm not a soldier. I'm one of the survivors from Scallets.
Huh. I see, lad. Well then, what do you need to know?
What in the world happened here?
The bastards attacked us. At night, a little before dawn.
And how did you come by that wound?
I heard someone talking, so I went to look outside. Then I saw what they'd done to the horses. I shouted at those bastards. Caught one by the cloak and started beating him.
Without a weapon? With just your fists?
Yeah. But he cut me pretty good, the fucker. Lucky for me, the others started to come out then, so the raiders ran. All that's left is his cloak.
And you've got no idea why they did it?
Something must have gone wrong for them. They ran off without taking anything.
There's one man in particular. Huge. Dressed all in black. Voice loud enough to crack stone. Did you see him?
Who the fuck do you think half killed me?
So he really was here. The bastard. Can you help me?
How?
You know the area. How can I figure out which way they went?
They left in a hurry. You could see if there's a fence knocked down, or a gate.
Doing?
Can I help? Who's there?
What are you doing here?
Hey! Look out! Oh, fog these days.
Are you deaf?
Now I'll teach you what clear off means. You should have thought twice about what you're doing. That will land you a fat fine.
All right, that's enough. Maybe you didn't realise, but I'm in the service of the Lord of Rattai. So you better keep that in mind.
I didn't know that. My apologies. Go ahead. What are you doing here? Enough of your shit. When I said clear off, I meant right now.
You should have thought twice about what you're doing. That will land you a fat fine.
Just my luck. Look, I can't tell you anymore.
The fate of the whole empire hangs in the balance between King Wenceslas and King Sigismund. High politics, you know? Not a peep to anyone.
Well, I thought, that is, I had no idea. If that's how it is, of course you may go. Surrender! You'll have to answer for your law-breaking.
God bless. Can I help you?
Good day to you. What do you need?
Let's talk about the price.
Well, we can try it.
Since it's you.
That's better. Drop it a bit more and we'll call it a deal. Aye, that would do it.
God be with you, Henry.